And Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1377. Mix two icon sets. Hey, welcome back. I'm Bill Jellin from Mr. Excel. Today's question sent in by Jordan. Now, Jordan has a great blog out here at Minus Design, and Jordan sent in this question. He wrote a nice blog post on conditional formatting. Traffic lights were used some if statements to, depending on words in another cell, he got the right traffic light to show up. But Jordan wanted to mix green, yellow, red, and also the pink, black, and gray, which are in two different icon sets. And normally, you can't do this, but I was kind of excited when I read Jordan's post because I know there's a way to do it. I couldn't remember. It was all the way back from February 2006. Dave Gayner, who was writing the Excel team blog, posted just a tiny little solution to this. And Microsoft has since taken it down because it's about Excel 2007. But luckily, someone somewhere stole it and copied it, and I was able to find that code again. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to mix this icon set with this icon set. So let's take a look at how we're going to set that up. First thing we're going to do, choose the range where we want to apply this. These are the colors I want to use. And 6 is green, 5 is yellow, 4 is red. And then switch over to the other icon set, the pink, the gray, and the black. So we have, in essence, 6 different colors. So I'll go to conditional formatting, icon sets, and we will apply the second one, the red, yellow, black, the lower numbers first, and then come back in conditional formatting, icon sets, and green, yellow, red. And as Jordan discovered in his notes to me, the first one gets overwritten and the second one is the only one that shows up. It's actually backwards. It's weird the way it works. I'm going to go into conditional formatting, manage rules, and here's what you'll see is the one that we set up most recently appears on top, and that's the one that we're seeing now. A couple of adjustments we want to do here. First thing is go in and edit the rule, and we want these to not be percentages but absolute numbers. And we're going to say, let's see, this red one I'm never going to use, so I'm just going to use an incredibly high number here if it's greater than 8. Okay, but the pink one I want to have show up when it's 3, and gray when it's 2. That leaves the black one to show up when it's 1. All right, now bear with me, we're going to get there. Edit the rule. Again, we'll change these to be numbers. This should be for 6, and that should be for 5. Click OK. All right, so we're getting the greens and yellows where they should be. Everything else is showing up as red. That's not what we want. All right, now, the Dave Gayner trick, this has to be something they were going to put in the Excel interface. They coded it up in the VBA interface and then decided not to put it in the Excel interface, but it's still left there in VBA. This is amazing. We have to notice that we are in cell E1. E1 is the active cell right there because the code that I'm going to use. So I'm going to press Alt F11, or if you have the developer tab, just Visual Basic. Press Control G. Control G will get you to the immediate window, and you're going to type something like this. Selection dot format conditions 1, that's the first one in the list, the green, yellow, red one, dot formula. Now there's no way to do this in the Excel interface, and I write a formula here that says, hey, if E1, remember that's the cell that is the active cell, is greater than 3, then I want to use this format condition. True. Otherwise, I don't. Press enter there, and we'll go back to Excel. And lo and behold, we're getting the green for 6, the yellow for 5, the red for 4. But then if it's not greater than 3, it stops using that first condition, and the second condition shows through. Now, I think the cool effect here, because Jordan was trying to not really show the numbers, he just wanted to show the icon. For each of these, if we manage rules, edit rule, and say show icon only. Now, we should have done that, of course, the first time through, but I wanted to see how this was working. Click OK. All right, so now you have your formulas here. By the way, it'll actually center the icon now. A very cool way to go. Thank Jordan for sending that question in, and thank David Gayner, formerly the project manager for Excel, for posting that way back in 2006. Very, very cool trick. Well, hey, all right, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.